feet are actually going to be wider than your mat. Because it is a sumo squat, you really want to make sure when you sit down that your knees are still behind your toes, but your knees are nice and wide. You're also going to want to make sure that you warn your students that they are going to be stepping back into the bowlers or a curtsy lunge, but that they really want to take a step back and still be able to see the railroad tracks in between. So instead of being on a balance beam, we want to be on two railroad tracks. Okay? Now again, I'm going to teach it with the beat of the music, the counts that we use, but never feel like you're stuck. If you want to go slower than this so that your students really understand it, and at the end of the day feel successful, that's exactly what you should do. You not only know your students best, but you also know when you go into a class when people just aren't getting it. So sometimes we have to reset in the middle of class and just go a little slower. Plus, don't be afraid of the slow. I say this time and time again, sometimes slower seems even harder because you're really gonna engage so many more muscles. So don't be afraid of the slow. Slower will never mean easier, and especially in this one. So, to start, take your feet wider than your mat. You really can't ever be too wide, but what you're gonna do is start going down for four. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Take the right foot back, down. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Back, center, down for four, and up for four. Other way, down, and up. So you notice that it takes eight counts at each spot, so it's eight here, eight, four down, four up, which is eight, four down, four up. Now you can do that for a phrase, you can do it for two phrases, if you feel like they need, or you feel like your class needs three phrases, then you go to three phrases. The next you could say is, all right, let's speed it up. So we're gonna go one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. So this would be two, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Three, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, two, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So again, we speeded it up, we're down for two, up for two. So now, instead of a phrase being four of them, it's actually eight. Again, you can do that for a phrase, you can do it for two, you can do it for three. Maybe even more if you want. Then, you're gonna speed it up even further and do singles. So you're gonna go one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, two, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Make sure you still talk about the transition because we don't want people flopping around. We want them to use their core so that when they're transitioning back, they keep that nice, strong, and controlled movement. All right, so obviously when you get to singles, moves a little faster, you're gonna do a lot more, but the second 32 count of singles, you can have the option of tapping down only if you want. And I always say it's just an option. Maybe try it once. If you don't like it, hey, you can just tap your knee or just stay exactly where you were before. All right? So you start off slow, down for four, up for four, every single side. Then you speed it up, down two, up two, go faster singles, singles. And then when you really want to feel it, you're going to get down long and pulse for eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Pulse for eight, pulse for eight, pulse for eight. Cut it in half, pulse for four, three, two, one. Pulse, four, three, two, one. Back, four, three, two, one. Other side. And again, you can finish the phrase, or maybe it's your first time teaching this and you just want to go pulse, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. And the killer, I think this is where you're like, wow, my legs are killing me. But this is where you gotta dig deep. You go back to singles for one last phrase. And you keep telling your class they can do it because you know they can. Shoulders are up strong because you gotta be tall and proud to be up here. Woo! I'm already running out of breath just showing you. Okay? So again, you know your class best. Maybe you need to ease them into this, but the plie de bowlers, when you start slow, this is where you can really cue the form and technique where they're sinking into their heels, where they're standing up tall, their shoulders are behind them, back is flat against the back wall. Set up and avoiding this, the hinging at the hips, so that when they move faster, they already start with fabulous form and technique. So when they move, it's still sharp, and they're still getting such an effective workout while still being safe. So enjoy, have fun.